Hey guys, Andy Crunchy back with Stranger Things episode 4. So a kind of scary episode, I'm guessing, because Max is under the same treatment as everyone else who's died. I'm curious how she's going to get out of this because none of the other characters really even stood a chance, really. So I don't know if there's a way out or not. But we have dealt with the Upside Down before, so she maybe stand a chance. I don't know. This is going to be interesting. Hopefully, Max survives. I don't want Max to die. I could see her being a casualty. My favorite character in the show, so I wouldn't want that. So no, hopefully they find a way. Because I believe there's not that many episodes, really. Yeah, there's still quite a few episodes left, but I know some of the episodes are quite long, so we'll see. But hopefully, yeah, let's pick it up. I'm enjoying it quite a lot. I'm looking forward to seeing where they're going to take L's training arc. And yeah, no, Evan's training arc. And yeah, overall, look forward to see what they're going to do with it. But guys, if you enjoyed the reaction, leave a like, subscribe, check out the episode, cut. Let's do this. Free to play.
Trouble sleeping. He'd wake up in a cold sweat.
Proper like Freddy Krueger vibes this season.
Worse until eventually.
I wonder what the escalation of is it though, because they escalated quite. Chrissy wasn't as fast as Freddy. I guess we don't know if he had it before actually.
His headache started a week ago.
Okay, here we go.
And I just saw that goddamn clock, so.
That is mildly terrifying. That's very. Max! They'll find a way around it, hopefully. Lucas, Jesus. Oh yeah, someone clarified he took him to the Hopper's cabin. Time to update. What would you, how do you fight that? That much about going to your head. I know they've still dealt with some crazy stuff. It's like, the friend's possibly dying the next day because of these visions. How the fuck do you stop that? Whoa, with Duck Hunt? Fuck.
That's what we're about to find out.
Same clear, better be making bank.
Trick, boys. Straightforward, my ass. You know what, honestly, Henderson? A little humility?
I love Steve. Is one thing about the long wait between. I don't know who characters I used to ship. Like, I can't really remember the Will's brothers that much. I remember liking him. It's like, oh.
Did I do something wrong? It says dial one, then the number.
I still don't know how I feel about them bringing Hopper back. I like Hopper. Just, he could have had such a perfect death.
He's not going to remember it, but for what is essentially a ransom.
As long as Hopper plays like a big role in this season, then I won't mind. But if he doesn't play hardly any other role, it should be a waste. It's one of those. I'm either going to really look back at this and like it, or I'm going to look back at this and be like, oh.
I could eat.
Oh, now I'm hungry. Mew. This is pretty much just been a taxi. I'm guessing anybody watched Takes to the Grave saw a little screenshot. Click on the episode just look preview.
I'm sorry, what is this?
It's
goodbye.
Wait, whoa, Max. Things are gonna work out.
No. See, this is where you badass and you burn the letter and then you're like, it's gonna be fine.
That it's all gonna work out because people have been telling me that my entire life and it's almost never true.
That's fair.
It's never true. I mean,
oh, I don't like the clock. It's scary. I don't like it. No. Excited to talk to this guy.
Because I wanted you to take us seriously. Because nobody takes girls seriously in this field. They just don't. We don't look the part or whatever, but can I tell you...
Nancy's face is great. Sorry.
And like such unimaginable acts. Other kids, they wanted to be astronauts. Basketball players, rock stars.
The passion.
I'll now try anything in my power, including wearing this ridiculous outfit, if I might get the chance to speak to the man that ignited my passion and learn a little bit more about how his twisted
Robin
fascinating mind works.
Did that actually that actually work. Robin. What a boss. I love Robin. I forgot how good she was. Her and Steve in the little sailor outfits for the whole season.
Trustworthy people, but so did my brother. Before he stole my wife.
Okay, he's got beef. I don't know if the guy's ever been serious.
Poor bird. You're freezing.
Reminds me of Pereira from Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
I don't know. I hate gore.
Hey, fucking battle. Imagine how intense it's been. This is your like, that you're fucked if you don't win this fight, sort of thing. Fucking hell. Imagine how cold his feet would be as well, running in snow. Gonna be at Call of Duty. Oh, good thing they've got shit aim. Jesus. Crazy American. Oh God. Hey!
Yes.
He's still gonna be watching in another room.
You've got me in a rebellious mood.
You don't get to this position by being an idiot.
I need to check on anyway, so.
He's so reporting you. Sure. Look at that sus face. I feel like he's the character of Dine as well, because he was introduced to.
Yeah, I mean, I never really unpacked.
New characters are like the most unsafe place to be in this show, like if you're a new character.
For what?
Hello there.
Oh shit. Hey, man's getting some kills. Hey, he's fucking getting shots off. Imagine the pressure, thinking the pressure like this right now. It'd be so terrifying. How many? Get drive, man! Drive! Oh, fucking hell. I don't know if I was just like them. Like, fucking drive. Yeah, I'd be scoffing these jaws. It would bring a tear to your eye. And that was Nutella after all that. It's not over yet, though. He sold him out. Oh, you traitor. Are they going to drag this storyline on? Hey, man's making bank. Oh, and he's drugged him. Oh, they extended this storyline out. Well, I didn't expect him to drag this on. I guess it makes sense in a lot of episodes. I guess it wasn't going to be that easy.
I mean, as fine as someone who's hurtling towards a gruesome death can be.
Yeah, that's not for this. I don't think it's going to help a situation much, really.
Yeah.
But technically, you survived.
I have been back from the war some 14 years.
We're going to gonna see. Oh, we're gonna see everyone murdered. This is gonna be brutal. It's gonna be like a Insidious episode. Oh, he's all gonna die horribly.
This is nice.
Yeah.
It was. Well, the kid's already off. So this is creepy. It's doing a better job than most horror movies do. Never that was the setup. I'm surprised he didn't just move. Guess you haven't got a choice though when you got just like you spent all the money on the house. Oh, which is first. Wanna see the this is gonna be another voice. It said Alice screams, so I'm assuming they're already dead. Oh, we did it to his eyes. Oh, God. Jesus Christ. This is kind of one of the brutal stories. What a stressful episode. So good, though. Oh, my God. Maybe that's why the kid's acting has come. Oh, it's not gonna switch, is it? I do not want to hear the clock noise.
I've been waiting to hear those words, Max.
Oh, he's not gonna use Billy. That's cruel on so many levels. Oh, he's so scary. I don't like him. Jesus. Back off, fam.
Time for you to join me.
What does he mean by joining him, though? Because he just kills them, so how did they join him? Oh, so now the car radio they've got, they're going to have to carry it to it. Right, she has a lifeline. Now she's just got to run like hell. Luckily, she's got a bit more of an open field.
Holy shit, holy shit!
You
really are a weird runner.
That was it. Lily would be proud of her friends. I gotta say, that's an impressive background. Jesus Christ. She's been listening to music earlier in the show. What was the song? Ugh. It made everyone roll out with this background. Jesus.
What are you doing in here, man?
Oh, the chills. Cindy. You must keep the souls there as well.
How do you like them, Max?
Probably a good thing he's showing off right now. That was satisfying. Oh yeah, this song. She's not getting out of there now, is she? Oh no, keep those fingers away from you. Oh no. This is... How are they gonna stop it? She best make that run. Yeah, that episode. I remember that episode being really good. They would have given us a little AMV. Imagine if they kill her right now. Nah. Oh, this could go either way. This could be help her escape or kill her. Okay. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, she best fucking make that run. It's going to do that thing in it. She's going to just make it and they're going to kill her. What's she... Oh, come on. I'll give the show one thing, because you don't know if they will kill off characters or not, they have done before. Oh, they're going to do it. Or they're going to keep it open and... Oh, they're going to end the episode, aren't they? Okay, thank fuck for that. I thought they were going to... Could you imagine if they did all that, she didn't fucking make it? That would have been brutal. Fucking Nancy and Robin coming through. Yeah, I wasn't sure if they were going to kill her off there. Because imagine if she did the run and they killed her off still. That would have been one of the most brutal deaths I've seen in a while. If they did. It's funny, I heard this song recently. There's a guy on YouTube who's just playing Running Up the Hill while running up a hill. Oh, shit, now. Jesus Christ. Ah, fucking hell, what an episode. Let's watch Winter Cheer is up. Should we watch that Running Up the Hill video? I'll show you guys the classic video. This video. I need a video to cheer me up. Fucking hell, I thought I'd actually kill him off there. Someone needs to do this video and edit Max's face over it. This guy's a legend. that video kills me. Jesus Christ, what an intense episode. Oh, fucking hell, that was scary. So I wasn't sure, like, they could have killed, because the show has killed off characters before, even though it will hop back, so it made me less nervous. The fact of the matter is, the show hasn't. I skilled off characters, so I wasn't sure if they would have. I could have saw it doing the whole thing. She gets to the portal, and then he dragged her back or something like that. That would have been fucking brutal. She definitely is one of my favorite characters. So I was like, ah, Jesus Christ, Nancy and Robin coming in. That story, the fact that that house story was done in like just not even that much time, and it was better than most horror movies. Like Jesus Christ, that poor guy. That no one believed him as well, and he's still living in hell. And that was just like, it was just a look at the music that he lived. Oh, and his poor kids and everything. Jesus Christ. I still don't get how it works, though. Like, I guess because he uses part of your mind, and he takes control of the same music he uses, so the music sort of makes you strengthen your resolve. I don't know. His power is a weird one. He can just, I guess, at the end of the day, this is like supernatural, so. There's a whole upside down world, so it could happen. It's just that the rules are a bit weird, but I guess it makes sense. No, a very, very good episode. I just thought I really enjoyed that episode. I think that was really, just really good. I'm looking forward to see what's going to happen in the next few episodes, especially the movie length episodes. The Hopper storyline, I'm a bit 50-50 on. I'm like, I don't know how I feel about them extending it, because my problem is with Hopper, right? Hopper's been kept alive. Now, if you're going to keep a character alive, that character needs to contribute towards the show. I remember the show I was watching where a character died and he moved the development of like five characters, and it was like really great and along the go through development. And they brought the character back and it sort of reverted all their development. It was like, because they just brought him back, and then, or brought her back, I should say. And then the worst part is, for the rest of the show, that character did nothing. So it was just like, they brought her back for the character to do nothing, and she couldn't contribute to certain things because of the way the show was done. So she'd literally come back for no reason, but also her coming back with her character's development. So with Hopper, I'm hoping it does something where he just play a big role in this season. But we've only got so many episodes left, because if he doesn't play a big role of this season, I'd be quite pissed with off of the storyline. The storyline will work if Hopper plays a role in the show, but if Hopper doesn't play a role in this show, that whole storyline would just be a waste of time. Maybe might come back into season five, but it's one of those I'm going to wait to see. Like, I definitely say it's more intense now with the betrayal, so getting out and everyone, there's more people in danger now, so there's more stakes in that storyline. So I'm curious to see. It's going to be one of those, like, when I finish it, I'll probably really enjoyed it, and when I rewatch it, I'll enjoy it. It'll be one of those when I get to the end of the season, I'll be like, why did we waste so much time here? You say they do all this and then he gets free anyway. It just feels like they're just using this to pad for time versus, say, a lot happens in Russia. Say this Russia storyline actually goes somewhere, then it's not just padding for time. Because at the end, they say he just say they go through a whole bunch of events now and they escape, but nothing's actually done in Russia. Well, not in Russia. I know it's not in Russia. That's Alaska. If nothing of urgency is done in Alaska, or they're not doing something at that side of the map, that's going to contribute to the main storyline. This is basically just padding time. But it could be where they actually do something in Alaska and there's a lot of stuff they're doing to do with the other side. And then that will make more sense. But if he's doing all this and then he's just going to be free at the end of it, they could have just freed him now versus dragging it on for another couple more episodes, then freeing him. So it's like one of those, it's like they need to, something needs to happen in Alaska that affects the main storyline. If they don't do this thing in Alaska, like, you know how like Nancy and Thing went to this mental institution, and if they didn't go there, Max would be dead right now. There needs to be something like that in Alaska. There needs to be something where if they don't do something there, other characters danger the other characters. Otherwise, this is just a waste of time of a storyline. So it's one of those. This could really pay off or it could not. I've not got hindsight, so I don't know. But I'm looking forward to see. I've got faith in the show that I can pull it off. But something needs to happen of importance in Alaska for this to be a reason for them to extend them being there, other than to give them a storyline. So I'm curious to see how it's going to go. Overall, another fantastic episode of Stranger Things. I look forward to see where they're going to take the next few episodes, especially longer episodes. I wonder if this, with the longer episodes, I don't mind them being longer episodes if they justify the length. I don't like it when shows just do movie length episodes because they feel like they have to do movie length episodes. So I look forward to see what they're going to do there. Sophie Port, unpopular opinion. I love Mike, and I hate the Hopper storyline. Actually, I fast-forwarded this part of reaction. Nothing about you, I just don't care about watching again. I've done 9 reactions. When I watch reactions, if I don't care about the part of the storyline, I don't really care about the reaction. The way Mike handles Elle was actually good. He went up and tried to talk to her with an actual conversation, reminiscing to her about being bullied too, that she wouldn't be so embarrassed. And him saying that the most credible person and she's superhero, but was so frustrating that he didn't tell her that he loved her. Was there a specific reason why he did that, why he wouldn't tell her? Jerry, I would have understood. So frustrated, but other than that, it's so sweet. I'm glad he's confronted her about the line to him and why she was telling him he deeply cares, and reassures her that he will get her out. Love Nancy and Robin team up. Mate, Nancy and Robin team up, I'm loving it. It's good. They've got like two very distinct personalities, so it works really well. Always the goddamn babysitter, Steve. I love Steve. Steve's a fucking legend. The best babysitter. He deserves the phrase. I'm surprised they would have just put her in jail anyway. However, she said she didn't know if she wanted Angela dead, so it's still a threat to society if she got murdered, though. But it's still extreme without getting in contact with parents. I don't know if it's one of those things just because it was like the 80s or something. I don't know. I'm curious. Dustin and Steve, bromance is superior. Glad to see Dr. Owen again. I'm glad Lucas didn't betray the group. They got back together. So scared for Max and more cliffhanger note. That was a very good episode with Max. Max is fucking carrying right now. Totally fair if you don't care for Mike and Elle's relationship, but for me, I love those two for the first season. See, this is the problem with the gap of me not watching season one, because with ships, I've always noticed this. You know, the longer a show goes on with massive gaps, and say there is shipping or there's romance and stuff, the further along it is from when you had those ship moments, I can't remember if I loved Jonathan and Nancy. Like, I think I did. I think I really loved them when I was watching the show, but when I'm watching the season, I couldn't tell you if I loved them, if you know what I mean. I couldn't tell you if I loved their relationship. But when the show's finished and I rewatch a show from one season one to the last show, I feel like I'd be more invested in romance stuff. I think romance is one of those where when you have large spaces between seasons or it's been a long show, it really does hurt it. So I'm curious there. Same sort of thing happened with Sex Ed, but I've seen it with other people, because even I never really shipped the main couple in Sex Ed, a lot of people, because it's been so long of them messing about, the people all fell out of love with it. And to be fair, this show isn't mainly about romance, whereas I'm guessing it's a more romantic based show, like I do with my anime. I sort of remember it a lot better, but the romance here is just a small part of the bigger story, so it's not something that sticks to my mind as much as like the Will's death and all the big things that happen in the show. So if it's just like a romance show, I sort of remember the romance a lot more, because it was like a smaller part of the show, but always a fun part of the show, because I like the slice of life stuff in the show, like the stuff like when more in early seasons. It's quite interesting how we retain it. It played such a huge part in season one already. The focus has been on those two. You being biased towards Will is the same as me being biased towards Mike, and I think it probably should be harder on him, but I just like him. That is just the character bias in general. Like, everyone just has a preferred character and preferred ships and preferred things, isn't there? So you justify characters more. You are right. It's just like, you know, you look at a character a lot meaner than you should. Like, I've done that. There's characters I just despise because I don't like the character and I won't accept their opinion. I try and tend to be level-headed in my reactions, and then even if I have a dislike for a character, I try and put my mind in their full presence. I think from their point of view, or I love playing devil's advocate, so I sort of have a leeway on that sort of stuff. But I know there's plenty of people where they watch it with just pure bias, and if they hate a character, even if that person's in the right in a situation, I've seen people just hate that character. There's been plenty of shows where I've understood what a character's doing and I'm not hating on them, whereas I've watched other people's reactions or watched it with people or seen forums online, but people just hate the character, and it takes like discussion videos to change people's minds or like change the viewpoint on a character. So it's quite interesting how that can all like lead. I messed up my comment, tried to edit them and only one more comment, but it seems I just deleted some of the copy them without copying them. Wow, I feel like an old lady. I feel most of it's showing up by the looks of it, so I hope so. Sorry if you did put more out. It's nothing more annoying when it happens. I know I've written out comments before and then I didn't save them and it didn't go, and I was just like, oh, Cynthia Paul, absolutely love Nancy and Robin team up, one of my favourite dynamics. Dustin calling out Steve because he has a thing for Nancy is such a great and funny scene. And for me, it's been so long that I don't even remember if I like Nancy and Jonathan together. See, that's how I feel. That's funny when someone agrees. I agree with that fully. So I don't know if I mind them breaking up. All I know is that since season two, Steve has been one of my favourites. I would fully agree with you. Lucas actually took them to Hopper's old cabin. See, I didn't realise that. I thought he actually took them to where he was. While I would join them back with the group, I was a bit worried until he definitely didn't lead them to where Eddie was hiding. Thank God. So scared for Max when she sees she's the same symptoms as the first victims. I've seen this group, you know, it's been a lot more gory. She can tell the show's sort of grown up with its audience and gone more gory, and I always appreciate that. I think like some shows try and stick with their audience, and it makes sense that. But when you get longer shows, it's better to grow up with the audience. Why Harry Potter movies always did so well, because it sort of grew up with the audience. Whereas if it stayed, all the Harry Potter stayed at the same level as Philosopher's Stone, it wouldn't have been as popular. Hopper scene is gruesome. It's just an example. They don't shy away from the gore this season. They do not. Like, that eye bit I come look at. Kind of shocked that Elle didn't get a lawyer in interrogation while police being a minor, but I'm glad that it wasn't going to be a whole Elle in jail arc. Much prefer that she worked with Owen and getting her powers back. Whatever, I can't remember what actually happened to those people she met who also were from this facility. What happened to all those kids? Like, well, I'm just misremembering that. Yeah, I guess the jail arc would have been just sort of like usual sort of arc. I don't know. Could have been fun, but then it would have been a bit much. Next episode is one that truly reminds me why I love the show, and I can't wait for next reaction. No, the horror and elements in this episode, fantastic. But yeah, guys, hopefully you enjoyed the reaction.